Senior health officers countrywide announced an industrial action over what they termed as failed dialogue with government over unpaid monthly allowances for the past 6 months. Today, led by the acting president of Uganda Medical Association, Dr. Edith Nako, they faced the Health Committee of Parliament in an attempt to resolve the impasse caused by the sit-down strike. According to senior health officers, government committed to pay them a monthly allowance of 2.5 million shillings, but they haven't received the money since October, and their calls for payment to the Minister of Health have been unanswered.
Nearly to a day, the Uganda Medical Association, in another meeting chaired by the Minister of ICT and the National Guidance, and together with the Ministry of Health and Minister of State's Primary Health Care and the Director General of Health Services, had a meeting, and we agreed still in that meeting and resolved that all senior house officers should be paid alongside the interns, and they were supposed to be given an allowance of 2.5 million shillings per month with effect from 1st July 2021. The document is attached in Annex 3. As previously covered in the previous directive given by His Excellency, the President of Uganda, the UMA appreciated, we, the Uganda Medical Association, appreciated and still appreciate this development, and the signed resolution and agreement in that meeting is also attached. Subsequently, however, all medical interns have been paid in both government and private hospitals this allowance. However, the SHOs in government universities have accessed this allowance only intermittently.
Dr. Robert Luvega, the leader of health senior officers, wondered why the Minister of Health takes them for granted, yet health facilities have started feeling the impact of the senior health officers' absence. The officers informed the committee that first-year officers based in Mulago, Chiruddu, Kawempe and Mbale Regional Referral Hospitals have not received their allowances since they reported to work study sites in October last year, while those in Kabale Hospital haven't received theirs since August 2022. However, health committee members led by the Padiel County legislator pleaded with the senior health officers to call off the strike and return to work as parliament presses government to release their allowances.
We want you to give the health committee an opportunity to resolve this problem. In return, we would kindly request you to call off the strike with immediate effect so that we work on this.
The chairperson of the health committee, Charles Ayumi, has promised to organize a joint meeting between the health ministry and the finance ministry to resolve the stalemate.
We have hit what they call an impasse in negotiation, where there is a stalemate. There's no winning on either side. And you clearly put it, and we feel your pain. But we're also messengers on this side. None of us here has a key to the treasury. And I would be lying to you if I told you that I have that button that I'll press today, and tomorrow your accounts will be credited. No, we're also messengers. We're different in the health sector. We have to go back to the budget committee. We have to go back to the Ministry of Health. A lot of consultations have to be met.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.